वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, माय सेल्फ के प्रेम सागर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन इंजीनियरिंग। या इन लास्ट क्लास आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशंस ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स, क्लासिफिकेशंस ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स। And that are classifications based on, there are three types of classifications are there, depending on, based on first classification based on first refractive index, and second classification is based on number of the modes, and third classification is based on what are the materials we have to using to make the particular optical fiber. Okay, here in last class, number of the first classification under the first classification based on refractive index. Then in refractive index also there are two types of classifications are there. First one is step index optical fiber, and next one is graded index optical fiber. Okay, coming to next classification based on modes. Now here, based on modes, there are the three types of optical fibers are there. First one is single mode optical fiber and multi-mode optical fiber and graded index multi-mode optical fibers. Is it clear up to here? Now these are classification under the number of the modes. Next, depending on type of the materials we are using. In this type of the material also there are the three types of the optical fibers are there. First type, what is first type is, that is based on glass core, glass cladding material, glass core, glass cladding optical fiber, and second one, glass core, plastic cladding optical fiber, or plastic core, glass cladding optical fiber. Okay, next, both here PM, that is next one, third one is plastic cladding. Core and cladding are made up of by using plastic only, that is plastic core and plastic cladding optical fiber. This is third, these are the classifications I already discussed in previous class. Okay, now I am going to discuss in this session, now I am going to losses in optical fibers. Before losses in optical fiber, what is losses? First of all, dispersion. Loss means that is nothing but a dispersion. Dispersion or attenuation, these are all under the losses only in optical fiber. Okay. Before, now I am going to the types of losses. Okay. Now I want to discuss basic thing, that is attenuation. What is attenuation? Is there attenuation? Is one type of the attenuation is also one type of the Here, that is also one type of the loss. Okay, now next, attenuation. What is attenuation? Here, attenuation means that loss of light energy when we have to transmitting any light ray from the transmitter to the receiver end. When now I want to transmitting one any incident ray. Here, if there is any losses is there at the receiver end, that loss is nothing but that is attenuation. And here, attenuation. It also called the signal loss or the fiber loss. Okay. It also decides the number of repeaters required between the transmitter and the receiver. Why we are required the repeaters? It also how we are deciding that number of the receivers, repeaters, number of the repeaters. Depending on the number of repeaters only, we can say that if suppose now I want to extend the fiber optic cable length. Okay, now. Now we have to place some one repeater. And that repeater function is, it is increasing the strength of the particular signal, optical signal. And also we have to extend the length, we have to extend the optical cable size also, we are using that repeaters. Okay. Next, attenuation is directly proportional to the always length of the cable. Always, that is length of the cable. Next, attenuation. Actually, what is the definition of the attenuation? Now I am going to that. It is the it is defined as the ratio of optical power output to the input power in the fiber of length L. Okay, it is the ratio of the attenuation. It is defined as the ratio of the optical output power to the input power. Okay, na? With the fiber optic length L. Here, attenuation constant is denoted by the symbol alpha, that is equal to formula, standard formula, 10 log of 10 base 10 P out. Sorry, here this is P out. P naught by P in. P out by output power by input power. The formula in this actually, what is units of attenuation, attenuation in decibels per kilometers. Where, what is PI? Input power, P naught is output power, alpha is attenuation constant. Okay? By using, we have to calculate the attenuation constant, attenuation. Now, various losses are there. When we have to transmitting a one incident ray, when we have to transmitting a any rays from the transmitter to the receiver, okay na? We have to transmitting a incident rays from the transmitter to the receiver, some losses are arised in the particular cable. Okay, na? Some losses are there in the particular at the receiver end of the part of optical fiber. The losses are due to, here basically the losses due to arises due to, first one is absorption, dispersion, scattering and bending. By using these four, there is losses is arised in the in any optical fiber at the receiver end. Is it clear? Now I am going to discuss about each and every one in detail. That means here each and in absorption is there, absorption losses are there, absorption losses, then again there are the classic two types are there. Okay, now scattering and dispersion and bending. Now I am going to discuss about detailed description of our losses. Next, losses in optical fiber, attenuation is the basic loss and dispersion. Dispersion means, what is this dispersion? The ray, the incident ray we are giving to the core, middle of the core, the axis of the core, after total internal reflection, the incident ray reflected within the core only, after at the, it will, then again it is total internal reflected, it will receive at the receiver end. Okay, it is received at the receiver end. When it is received at the receiver end, some dispersion, the dispersion means the where whatever the ray we are giving at the input side, that means at the core, it is away from the core and cladding medium. Okay, na? That means that is nothing but a dispersion. Here in dispersion, there are the two types of the dispersions are there: intramodal dispersion and intermodal dispersion. Intramodal dispersion and intermodal dispersion. Now next one. Now I will discuss that types of dispersion in next slide. Okay. Next one is, next type of the losses is bending losses. In bending losses, due to some bending of when we are installing a any particular optical cable, is there some chance of getting there is chance of bending of our optical fiber. Okay, na? Due to the bending also some losses are arise. Okay, na? In this bending losses, there are two types of the bending losses are there: microscopic bending losses and macroscopic bending losses. Okay, microscopic bending losses and microscopic bending losses. Okay, next type of losses are absorption losses. Due to absorption, higher absorption also, depending on that particular, due to some heating elements, yeah, heating elements inside of the particular optical core, optical fiber core, there may be chance of getting absorption of our incident ray. By using that also, there is losses are arise. Okay, na? There is here absorption losses are, two types of absorption losses are there: intrinsic absorption loss and extrinsic absorption loss. Intrinsic absorption loss and extrinsic absorption loss. Okay, na? Next, scattering losses. Losses. In the scattering losses are here, the scattering losses are mainly, why it arise? Due to proper making of the particular optical fiber, the scattering losses are arise. And proper internal, there is no proper internal reflection, the it is scattering losses are arise. Okay, na? In this scattering losses also, there are two types of the scattering losses are there: First one is linear scattering losses and second one is non-linear scattering losses. In this linear scattering losses, then again there are the three types of the scattering losses are there. First one is Rayleigh scattering losses and my scattering losses, and third one is waveguide scattering losses. Okay na? Rayleigh scattering losses, second one is my scattering losses, and third one is waveguide scattering losses. And coming to this, these are under the linear scattering losses. Now coming to non-linear scattering losses, first one is SBS scattering losses and second one is stimulated Raman scattering losses, that is SRS scattering losses. These are under the classification under dispersion, that means losses. Here losses are generally, there are actually the losses are due to losses, how the losses are arising due to the absorption, scattering and bending and what is this, scattering and bending, dispersion. Okay na? In this four, by using this four, that signal losses are arise in any optical fiber. Now first one is bending losses. Now I am explaining bending losses, why the bending losses is arise. The loss, I already explained this, the loss which exists when an optical fiber undergoes bending, okay, na, is called bending losses. There are two types of bending losses are there, microscopic bending losses and macroscopic bending losses. What is microscopic bending losses? First one is macroscopic bending losses. In this bending, macroscopic bending losses, if suppose, either that may be core or cladding, is bended. If suppose the total structure of the optical fiber is bended, then microscopic bending losses are arisen. How it is arisen? The bending is in which complete the fiber undergoes bends, which causes the certain mode not be reflected. Okay na? That is macroscopic bending losses. Here, this is my optical fiber cable. In this optical fiber cable, here. In this optical fiber cable, there are the, now I am incidenting three incident rays are there. First one is, this one is my first incident ray, and second incident ray, this one is my third incident ray. Here, red and yellow and blue color, these are the incident rays. Due to after total internal reflection, it is refracted within the core only, back to the core within the core only. And here, due to some bending, this ray, this red color ray, it will goes to the away from the core medium, core and cladding medium. Due to, it is away from the core and cladding medium, due to that, here there is no total internal reflection is there. Okay na? That's why, here there may be signal losses there in a macroscopic bending. This is about macroscopic bending. Next, microscopic bending. What is microscopic bending? Here, in this microscopic bending, here, due to bending of any surface, due to that bending of, when we are installing my optical fiber, when I am installing the optical fiber, due to, if suppose now some external forces now I am applying from the above the optical fiber, there may be chance of it will damage the core and cladding medium. Okay, na? Due to that, here there is no internal reflection is occurred in the particular core medium. That's why, now core medium, here there are three incident rays are there. Here also there are three incident rays. Due to this bending, this ray away from the core and cladding medium, it is not totally internally reflected. Here also some loss is there. This is microscopic bending. In macroscopic bending, due to the bending of our optical fiber, there is loss is there. Okay na? Here in microscopic bending, due to the bending of our any medium, that may be core or cladding, the ray, it is away from the core medium. Okay na? Due to that, losses arise. Next, here, these are microscopic bending. Either core and cladding undergoes light bends at its surface, it causes light to be reflected at an angle when there is no further reflection. This is microscopic losses, bending losses. Okay, due to this bending. Here this ray is away from the this due to this here also core surface bending. This ray away from the core medium. Okay. Next, absorption losses. Now I am going to absorption losses. Till now, are you understood or not? Is it okay? Now absorption losses. Absorption loss. What is absorption loss? Absorption of light energy due to eating of iron impurities results in dimming of light at the end of the fiber. Heating of iron impurities are there. Is there any heating process going on there on the particular optical fiber cable? Due to that, impurities results in the dimming of our optical light at the end of the fiber. Here there are two types of optical fibers are there. Here also absorption losses. Two types of absorption losses are there. First one is intrinsic absorption loss and the second one is extrinsic absorption loss. What is intrinsic absorption law and what is extrinsic absorption law? I will discuss now. Intrinsic absorption law. It is caused by the interaction with one or more components of glass. Interaction of one or more components glass. Here our fiber optic generally it is made up of silicon material. Now I want to same now when we are connecting, when we are extending my fiber optic cable, extending, now I am using connector. And the connector, when we are interacting with these two cable by using the connector, there is proper interaction is not there. That is nothing, not there. The signal, there may be loss. Okay, na? At that place. That nothing but intrinsic absorption. Occurs, it occurs when photon interacts with an electron in the valence band and excites it to the higher energy level near the UV region. Okay. It will go to the new ruby region. Okay, this is intrinsic absorption. Now coming to extrinsic absorption means what? Also called as impurity absorption. Extrinsic absorption is called impurity absorption. Results from the presence of transition of metal like iron, chromium, cobalt, copper, or OH ions from water. Okay, now due to this, here extrinsic absorption is there. Next, third one, dispersion losses. Dispersion means it goes away from the core cladding medium. That is nothing but a dispersion losses. Here dispersion, there are two types of the dispersion losses are there. Intramodal dispersion and intermodal dispersions are there. Here as an optical signal travels along the fiber, it becomes increasingly distorted. Increasingly it distorted. This distortion is a sequence of intramodal as well as intramodal. That's why these are the two types of the dispersions are there. What is intermodal and intramodal dispersion? Intermodal dispersion. Intermodal dispersion means what? Here this intermodal dispersion, because pulse broadening due to the intermodal dispersion results from the propagation delay difference between the modes within a multimode fiber. In this multimode fiber, here propagation delays are there. Multimode fiber means what? More than one rays we have to transmit it from the transmitter to the receiver. Okay, now in the multimode fiber, when we are giving a multimodes to the particular optical fiber, okay, now there is propagation delay is there. Propagation delay. Where the propagation delay is there? Due to where the total internal reflection is there, one ray, it will reach the cladding surface fastly. Okay, na? And one ray, it reach the cladding surface slowly. Because of, depending on the order of the, priority of the order of the rays. Okay, na? Lower order rays are there, higher order rays are there. Okay, and zero order rays are there. Lower order rays are always received at the receiver side, slower receiver than the higher lower order receiver. Okay. Now, between the modes, pulse broadening due to the internal dispersion results from the propagation delay difference between the modes within the multimode fiber. Okay. Next, intramodal dispersion. In intramodal dispersion within the particular core, there is dispersion is there. Okay, now it is pulse spreading within the core. That means when on the core the light, total light rays are there. Intermodal dispersion means that means it is applicable for multimode optical fibers, and intramodal dispersion means it is applicable for single mode fibers. Okay, na? Intramodal dispersion. In this intramodal dispersion, it is applicable for single mode fiber. That's why here intramodal dispersion, there are two types of intramodal dispersions are there: material dispersion and waveguide dispersion. Due to material also, what are the materials we are using to make the particular optical fiber, that also there is dispersion is there, and waveguide dispersion. Second one is waveguide dispersion. In this material dispersion, first one is, now I am going to the first dispersion, is that is the material dispersion, also known as the spectral dispersion and chromatic dispersion. It is spectral dispersion and chromatic dispersion. Results because of variation to the refractive index of core as a function of wavelength, because of which pulse spreading occurs even when different wavelength follows the same path. Okay, na? This is material dispersion. Different wavelengths follow the same path. That's why here our material dispersion is arise. Now, waveguide dispersion. What is waveguide dispersion? When we are transmitting any ray, it is transmitting any ray from the transmitter to the receiver. Out of that, 100% of the ray, it is not received at the receiver end. 80% of the ray is transmitted from the core medium, and 20% of the ray, it will go to the surface of the cladding medium. Power in cladding. Okay, that is waveguide dispersion. Next, last dispersion is scattering dispersion. Scattering dispersion means, yes, scattering dispersion. It occurs due to microscopic variations in the material density, compositional fluctuations, and structural inhomogeneities and manufacturing defects. Okay, na? Manufacturing defects also, some losses are arising that is nothing but scattering, due to that scattering losses. Here in the scattering losses there are two types of losses. First one is Rayleigh scattering losses, Mie scattering losses, and third one is waveguide scattering losses. First, now I am going to the Rayleigh scattering losses. Okay, the scattering losses arise due to the variation, microscopic variations in the material density. That means the silicon material we are using, okay, na? Material density also here, the losses are scattering losses. First, linear scattering losses. Okay, Rayleigh scattering losses. In this, first one is linear scattering losses. In this, these are the three types, and non-linear scattering losses, these are the two types, SBS and SRS. Okay, non-linear scattering losses. Linear scattering losses. What is linear scattering losses and what is non-linear scattering losses? Now we have discussed. Here, linear scattering losses, Rayleigh scattering losses. These losses are due to microscopic variations in the material of the fiber. Okay, na? What are the material? We have to microscopic variation in the material due to that losses are there. Unequal distribution of molecule densities or atomic densities leads to Rayleigh scattering losses. Okay. Glass is made up of several acids like SiO2, P2O5, okay, na? And etc. Compositions. Fluctuations can occur because of these several oxides, which rise to Rayleigh scattering losses. Rayleigh scattering losses. Yeah, this is Rayleigh scattering losses. These are scattering is there. After total, it is this ray is scattered. Okay, now next, yeah, these are also light scattering. These are the particles. Okay, now light, when it is reaches, when it is strikes the one particle with this ray, is away from the core due to that relay scattering losses or arise. Okay, light waveform, these are light waveform, these are the particles. Okay, particles on the particular core medium. Next, my scattering losses. These losses, second one is my scattering losses. These losses results from the compositional fluctuation and structural inhomogeneities and defects created during the fiber and fabrications. Fiber fabrication causes the light scatter outside the fiber. Okay, due to the fluctuations also, the losses are there. That losses is nothing but my scattering losses and waveguide scattering losses. It is result of the variation in the core diameter. Variation of the diameter is also, there is losses are there. And imperfection coupling, core cladding interface also, that losses are arise. These losses are waveguide scattering losses. Next, non-linear scattering losses. What is non-linear scattering losses? Here, there are scattering losses are there. First one is SBS scattering losses. Stimulated Brillouinian scattering loss. Stimulated Brillouinian scattering loss. Maybe it regards as the modulation of the light of modulation regarded as the modulation of light through thermal molecular variation within the fiber. Due to the thermal molecular variation also there is some losses are there. That is by we have to calculate that thermal variation by using this formula PB. That is PB, that is equal to 4.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 d square lambda square alpha into dB watts. Okay. Next, where lambda is operating wavelength in micrometers, d is fiber core diameter, v is source bandwidth in gigahertz. This is SBS scattering. Coming to the last scattering is, that is SRS scattering. Here in this SRS scattering, stimulated Raman scattering is similar to the SBS, except that the high frequency optical photon rather than the acoustic phenomena is generated in the scattering process. Okay, now here SRS scattering is you have to calculate it by using this PB. The formula is, the standard formula is 5.9 into 10 to the power of minus 2 to d square lambda alpha dB watts. Okay, this is SRS scattering. Here these are the different losses are there. Microscopic loss. Here in this picture there are different losses are there. Here this bubble is there. If this bubble is arised due to the external, when we are applying the external force, this bubble is arised in the between the core cladding surface. And this is absorption loss. Some particle, extra particle is there. Due to this particle, this incident rays are absorbed. And these are the scattering losses are there. Okay, now. And this is structure. When we are coupling, or extending, we are connecting other devices. Also, mismatching of coupling, also there is losses are arising. Okay, now. This is microbending losses. Now, these are also different types of angular misalignments. When we are connecting one more ray, one more optical fiber, angular misalignment also losses are there. And axial misalignment. Axial, if it is we are coupling any optical cable to the another optical cable, the axis must be equal. Then only we have to transmit our transmitter, the incident ray from the transmitter to the receiver. And end separation. End separation also, we are receiving at the both the end separation, we are joints are there. One starting joint is we are connected to the end, one more starting joint only. End separation also we have to connect, we have to arise some losses. And surface finish. If it is surface not smooth, is not there, there is losses are there. These are also some losses are there in optical fiber. With this, I am closing this dispersion part. Now I am going to tomorrow explain next topic.